Welcome to your Raise the Bar Pro Tip of the Week. We are back with Travis Tucker, regional manager for Ketel One. You know, we've talked about the history of Ketel One. We've talked about the botanical line, which is just blowing up. So exciting to see. I really want to talk now about the industry as a whole, right? The consumer now versus the consumer 5 and 10 years ago is so drastically different. It's forced all the brands from Marriott to Ketel One to really adjust the way of thinking. The approach that we're taking with the consumer. And I think that they're looking for that. They're looking for that experience, right? They're looking for those experiential moments. We talked about the labeling being different on packages. What would you say is that one thing or a few things that you've seen over the past 10 years transition and change because the consumer driving something different?
You're 100% correct. You know, over the last 5 years, the upper echelon of bartending was spirits knowledge, craft cocktail. That's the standard now.
It's a given that you're going to make us a great drink.
Exactly. And you're going to know what's in that drink, where it came from, about the particular brand. So where do we go next? I think experiences, right? I think that's the next upper echelon of cocktail service.
Yeah, and I think when I think about experiences, we always talk about cocktails in three ways. First, the visual, then the nose, the aroma, and then the flavor profile, right? But, you know, and I think when we look at things like the botanical line and some of the stuff that Ketel's doing, the ability to create those experiences become almost more rewarding. Because now we actually know what we're talking about, right? When we talk about the bartenders and those mixologists in our hotels, you know, the level of education is so much greater than it was 10 years ago that I think for the consumer, it's exciting because it's no longer just saying, I'm getting a good cocktail. Like, oh, wow, that was a cool drink. What was in it?
Yeah.
I mean, now we're sitting down, we're getting the history of the product. We're getting stories attached to it. The botanicals that's used for garnishes attached to those drinks is mind-blowing. I think a lot of the gimmicks that were used for a long time is now going back to the basics of just creating greatness. And that's from the stories to essentially the product itself. Is there anything that you would tell the bartenders that are gonna be watching this to say something that you're seeing or something that you've experienced? Maybe you've experienced at one of the hotels that these guys are bartending at that can set them apart from what other bartenders are doing.
Well, it's funny you ask that, Chris. You know, when Carl Nolet Sr., our 10th generation master distiller and owner of the Nolet family distillery, came to the United States, he knew that he had to create something that could stand up to the other vodkas at the time on its own, because the bartenders in the United States were true craftsmen, and they've only gotten better since then. Yeah. So to answer your question, I think vodka really shines when it comes to seasonal ingredients, especially today. You know, we talked about the botanical movement and the holistic lifestyle, knowing what's in your food and drink, more educated consumer, if you will. And seasonal ingredients, excuse me, play into that. I right now do not think there's a better spirit that highlights seasonal ingredients better than vodka.
I couldn't agree more. And you know, one last question I have to ask you. We're seeing it when we talk about trends, right? I get asked this question a million times of what's the next trend in beverage? And a lot of the trends that we're hearing nonstop right now is that hotel bars are going to become the hot, relevant spot again. When we go across the pond and we're in London, right? They're the hot spots. If you're in London, the hottest bars are in the hotels. And I think we're seeing, would you agree that you see that in the US that hotel bars are becoming relevant again? And we're seeing the talent level in the bars and the beverage programs at these hotels really kicking up. Is that a fair assessment?
I would agree 100%. I mean, obviously thanks to you and your staff, but also I think hotels specifically were tired of providing these exceptional experiences other than the bar, then guests leaving to go get an experience elsewhere.
Yep.
So they're like, let's bring those guests back in. Let's maintain that business through the bar and elevating our standards. And, you know, we were at the Irvine Spectrum over the weekend, had a great pop-up there. Some of the best craft cocktails I've had in the last year.
We know that pop-up.
Do you?
Y&K did a pop-up at Irvine Spectrum. And honestly, because we are seeing the value in beverage programs, in cocktail programs, in hotels, and our consumer is starting to respond. We are seeing more and more guests stay on property to experience your cocktails because you guys are putting in the work, you're putting in the effort to really elevate your craft game. And so it's an important thing that needs to happen, continue to happen, so we can continue to work with iconic brands just like you guys.
100%, and that's all the craft cocktail movement is. It's not a 10-ingredient cocktail. It's using premium spirits, fresh ingredients, made well.
You've heard it here. Hotels are the new hotspot for beverage. Kettle agrees with us, so it has to be true. Make sure that you guys are bringing in Kettle One. It is a product that we want to make sure that our consumers are being able to taste, especially with this new botanical line that they've produced. Guys, it is something that we need to have out there. We need to continue to push the envelope exactly what you're doing now. This has been your Raise the Bar Pro Tip of the Week.